Jeg hedder Emma.
Og jeg hedder Sofie.
Vi er blevet sendt afsted af Alternativet for at finde ud af, hvad der rører sig ude i Europa og EU. Så det skal vi blive meget klogere på de næste 3 uger.
Toget holder stille lige nu, og vi ved ikke rigtig hvorfor. Vi var lidt bekymrede først for, om de havde givet en eller anden besked på polsk, som vi ikke havde forstået. Men vi bliver bare siddende og håber på det bedste.
What's not to like?
Der kopholder!
Hvad sker der?
Vi har fået gratis kaffe.
De ved fandme, hvordan man laver god service i Polen. Lige kommer over grænsen, så er der bare free coffee.
Tidslomme, fordi i Polen der er stadig december. Det er omkring den 19. december.
Det er på husene, med træerne, så klart, at vi kan drikke gløgg og varm kakao i de små
boder. Vi har taget lidt til den anden ende af byen for at mødes med... Kan vi tage den op?
Det er vi i hvert fald.
Vi er taget til den anden ende af byen for at mødes med Joanna, som skal fortælle os lidt om, hvad der foregår i Polen af politik, hvordan det er i deres parti, eller i det parti, som hun repræsenterer, Razem. Det bliver mega spændende, så nu tuller vi bare lidt rundt i det her område, inden vi skal mødes med hende på en café.
The political situation in Poland right now is a bit difficult. Or rather very difficult, not only because we have a very conservative right-wing government which is implementing a lot of policies that are undermining the rule of law and the importance of courts and diminishing the influence of independent media, but also because we have this extreme polarization between exactly the right-wing conservatives and the liberal, so-called liberal opposition. In this context, Razem really tries to break between these two, but also talk about the bad things that the current government is doing, how they're undermining democracy. But also offer solutions that would maybe help with the growing inequalities and the feeling of injustice that have been created by the people that are now voting as the members of the opposition. What we have in Poland is, we often call it the neoliberalism on steroids. Our government decided to deregulate the job market, and by now 1/3 of people working in Poland do not have a fixed employment contract. So you can imagine what that does to people that don't have any stability, any security. They can be basically fired from 1 month to another. And I'm not surprised that so many young people left for other European countries. And we had not only people leave for the UK, especially at the beginning, but also for Germany and France. And of course, also very worrisome, it created a condition of sense of inequality and injustice that translated to a lot of people turning to vote for the right wing. And this is how the Law and Justice Party came to power in 2015. So I think what is really needed right now is to not fall into this trap of these two opposite poles, but really talk about the future of Poland. And where is it that we want to be in 5 years, 10 years, 25 years? I am actually optimistic that spring is coming. I think we're currently in the darkest moment of the European winter, so I'm not surprised that a lot of people are not feeling very optimistic. But I think the signs of a positive change are there. And one of the things is this generational change that I talked about, that I saw a lot of young people in Poland, in Germany, and around the world really have a reaction that we've always been waiting for, of saying, I want to be part. I don't want to be standing by and just watching. I want to join either a social movement or a political party, becoming much more engaged, well-informed and active.
Vi er jo i Polen. Vi sidder i vores... Jeg kan ikke nå at snakke, hvis jeg var. Og om 6 dage skal vi være i Athen. Makedonien er no-go, fordi de er i skændelse med Grækenland, så der kan vi ikke komme igennem.
Fuck, hvor er der langt.
Og vi vil også rigtig gerne have et par dage i Budapest, vil vi ikke?
Jo.
Fordi vi skal jo lige...
Vi skal til Budapest.
Vi skal til Budapest. Vi har mega mange seje aftaler i Budapest. Og så skal vi bare
bruge 13 timer til Budapest.
Ingen kvaler.
Det må man ikke sige på YouTube, Emma.
Forlede mig, det er jo lidt.
Hvordan ser man det? Hvor skal de sidde hen? Sektor... Jeg forstår det ikke. Vi kom lige lidt sent ud døren, fordi vi skulle have aftensmad med på vej. 53.
Og man kan ikke tage lyset, så man lige kan så ikke lige vise jer vores kopé.
Jeg ligger lige hurtigt vores billetter her.
Jo, der.
Warszawa fik vi jo spist meget traditionel polsk mad.
Hvad fik vi, Emma?
Jamen, vi fik både piroger.
Pirokker
og polsk gulasch og øl og vodka.
Der er sådan en dårlig.